happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here, back again with another video. And today we are back on MAFM V2 in FS13. I just finished re-raking the hayfield because I had had a mod issue that deleted my save games, and my save game backup was before all the raking, so I had to re-rake everything. Instead of getting the Crone rake, I bought the Tanuti. V-rake, and then I had to run that with the Magnum, or the Puma, I mean, sorry, because this thing would not get up the hill there very well with that rake on. I'm hoping it does better here on the baler. If not, the Puma is staying up there. The farmer here had talked to me one day and said that if I wanted to, I could just leave the equipment here. He said he doesn't have anything going into storage anymore, so said if we would like to, we could just leave everything here instead of have to, you know, drag it back and forth, which is pretty nice. That'll definitely help. And all we gotta do is just bring one or two tractors over here, and we'll be all set. So hopefully we get our I'm going way too fast. Hopefully we can get our 70 bales off of here. Pretty fast, which at the rate that we're going, looks like we might get them pretty fast. Because we haven't even gone very far and we got a bale already. Which is definitely going to be nice, because if we can get a lot of bales off of here without making, you know, without baling much of the field, then we can go ahead and get a bunch of silage off of here as well. And the farmer did offer to offer us his bunker silo here, but I said for feeding purposes, having the silage at home would be just a whole lot easier. We wouldn't have to drive all the way over here with the mixer wagon and loader and whatnot. So plus, because we're using the Bobcat to load, that would even make that a whole lot more annoying. So, and then here in just a moment, so yeah, as you can see there, we also have the Farmall 1206 cultivating the wheat field. I got him going, so far he's doing pretty good. I was kind of hoping when he got to the waterways he'd lift the cultivator, but he doesn't. So the grass in the waterways is gone, but whatever. That's fine by me, I guess. Not that worried about it, I guess. So that's four already, and we haven't even completed one windrow, or even half of it. So now comes the fun part, because I know this bale will be full up here on the hill somewhere. So now comes the interesting part. That wasn't too bad. The bale's not even rolling, thankfully. Although if it did roll, that wouldn't matter much either, I guess. We'd still get it picked up. Alright, so this thing went up the hill pretty dang well with this. So that's good. So then after this, all we gotta do is make some silage and then buy our cattle, and then we'll be all set to start selling or start making some milk and getting that sold and whatnot. Whoa. Yeah, we are one step closer to that. We're a tenth of the way of the bales that we need. Hopefully we can make some more. If I don't have the 70 bales, or 69 bales, I guess we don't actually need the full 70. If I don't have 69 bales by the time I'm halfway done with this field, I'm just gonna stop baling and just start making some silage, because we can always go and cut the hay again, but I'd rather not cut it again just to, you know, I'd rather not be baling this whole thing and then going back and cutting it again to be able to get silage off of it. So we'll see how many bales we have, and we'll go from there. How much fuel's this guy got? 27. Okay, so we better grab the pickup here and get that guy topped off. So if you guys watch the Thursday modding series, if you saw the last Thursday, I said that I'd be revealing a new secret project, either, you know, here this Thursday or next Thursday. It's definitely not going to be this Thursday. I'm not sure if it'll be next Thursday either. I want to have a bit done on it before I do a video of it. And at the moment, I don't have all that much done on it. So there you can see it's getting rid of the waterways. But yeah, I don't have a whole lot done on it right now. I'm still trying to figure out, you know, how I want to set everything up. So come on, refuel guy. Come on. There we go. Perfect. This guy fills up pretty quick, so that that'll be fine. Alright, and we're out of his way. And back to bailing. But yeah, so that project, I still have a little ways to go before I want to show it. So yeah, this Thursday modding video, I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do yet. I haven't fixed my duo lift trailer, so maybe I'll get that fixed, I don't know. We'll have to see, I guess. Just have to see what happens, because I have a lot of off-camera work to be done on the Clover series, and then I also need to do the Thursday modding video. I have to have one more Clover video recorded. I have to record one more of this, and then record two My Summer Car videos as well. So still got a fair amount of stuff to do. Thankfully, I don't have to shovel anything anymore. My neighbor finally came back to town. He must have gone home. And he came back today and had a bobcat with him. And he cleaned out the snow for me in our area. And so now I don't have to worry about doing that anymore. So instead, I went and got the battery taken out of my pickup since it's done for. I went too long without starting it, and I think the battery froze. so not able to use that battery anymore. So I'll have to buy a new one. Took a while to get it out though, because there's, you know, first off, you know, I had the negative cable unhooked already, but the positive cable, the bolt holding that one, is kind of screwy. It was really messed up and like corroded and just garbage, and I thought I was just gonna have to break it off, but I finally got a pliers on there, and finally it, you know, it took a while before it actually gripped onto the bolt, but once it did, I finally got that thing off. And then it took a while to get the battery itself out, because there's a little, like, I don't know if it's plastic, or I think it was plastic maybe. You know, there's this little kind of like a block like thing that's bolted in that holds the battery in the front, and then the battery box holds it down in the back. So so I had to undo that bolt on that box, or, you know, holder, whatever the heck it is. And then there's like that much space to sit there and crank with, and I could not find all of the extensions for the ratchet that I wanted, and so I was stuck using the smallest ratchet because I couldn't get any of the other ones. And it was like, you have got to be kidding me. It was just such a pain. And then finally I found the small extension I was looking for. It's basically, you know, it's like maybe that big, and on one end it has a large end for like the our medium sized ratchet that we have, and then the other end is for like the smallest, the, you know, the sockets for the smallest ratchet we have. So I've got that, and then got two more extensions, you know, two bigger extensions, and was finally able to clear, you know, the top of the top of the chassis, and finally got it out. And then got it out, set it down, and now we're on to doing this. And that guy is skipping right there. I downloaded a bunch of new cultivators. I haven't put them into the mods folder yet. But when I do, this time I'm going to remember to take out a backup of the save game file or folder before I put the mods in there. That way, if I have stuff get deleted again, it's, I'm still up, you know, I'm up to date. You know, I'm current. So we're at 17 already, so we should be able to get our full amount. We'll just kind of have to see, I guess, though. There goes that bale. Yeah, I'm missing quite a bit, but not too terribly worried about it. We can always get it the next time, or if I'm going around with the forage wagon, can pick it up. Or like here, turning around, I can pick some up. But I'm not gonna go like out of my way just to pick it up. Get lined up with this pass. And I guess pick up that little section in the meantime as well. That's 19. And really, when it comes to feeding and stuff, having, you know, the amount of straw that you need is greater than the amount of hay, because usually with straw you put down your bedding, so you need more straw in order to be able to do that, and the hay, it just gets fed. You can feed the hay on its own too, but normally I just feed the TMR and then put down some straw for bedding, and then that's it. This is 21 or 22. Yeah, 22 already. Yeah, we should definitely be able to get that. We're only two passes in and we're already at this, so. I kind of turned a little sharp on that. We've run 93 bales through this baler already. Definitely putting it through its paces. We haven't even had it that long. Maybe what I'll do is I'll finish like this row, since this one also goes all the way around. Finish this one and we should have like 30, maybe I'll say 30 to 35 bales, and then we'll pick up enough. Let's see, because how much does this thing hold? Thing holds, so it can hold 31,000. So I think maybe what I'll do is fill it twice or something like that. Yeah, we'll fill it twice, and then we'll continue baling. We're gonna use the Puma for that because the Puma is like 200 and some odd horsepower. This thing's only like a little over 100. So the Puma can run that a whole lot better than this thing can. Plus then we don't have to unhook this baler and hook it back up. Really? Let's see, we've got. So we got 8 windrows left. So we should be able to get a couple trailer loads off of here, I would assume. Well, let's kind of see how much, because we're at 27. So if we can get like 30 bales, which we should, then we can start picking up and then just kind of see, you know, if it takes all 8 of these windrows to get 2 forage wagon loads out of here, then so be it. Then we can just make more hay with make more hay the next time. And this is number 29 here, so yeah. Yeah, so that's what we can do, and then we'll have, you know, we'll have a few bales. You know, it's a little under half of what we have for straw, but that's all right, I guess. Okay, so we'll just stop here at 30. Oh, I guess it's kind of good that we did, because we're out of net wrap anyways. So we'll have to go to town and get a... We'll have to haul the bobcat to town, and I gotta buy pallet forks too then. Okay, so then we'll just run up. See, how's this guy doing? He's getting there. So we'll grab this guy. And we'll just run and go grab the forage wagon. See how much time we got left. 8 minutes. Come on. Go. Want to be able to pick up some... Get at least one load before the video's over. Yeah, then after this video, I'll just finish up the baling and, you know, finish up all this hay work, get the bales hauled and stacked, and then the next video we'll work on whatever else, on the getting the cattle going. Planting will definitely be a bit of a task because of how much land there is and how small our planters are at the moment. Jeez, collision for that sticks out a ways. Holy smokes. Okay, so I gotta remember, I think it's, you just unfold construction. Yeah, that's all it is. Ah, yes. Okay, so let's... Okay, perfect. Okay, let's go get some haylage. Get some hay picked up, make some haylage, I guess I should say. So then eventually, you know, we can let our manure and slurry stockpile for a while too, and then eventually can buy the equipment to use to haul that, and we can sell it, make extra money from it, or could use it as fertilizer, but a lot of the time that stuff runs out way too fast, and then you end up, you know, you don't have it all on all of your fields. Hi. I definitely really like this trailer. It's nice. Works really great. It's cruise level 2. Hopefully we can get a decent amount of this. If not, I'll have to just kind of go mow some other areas, some like ditches or something, mow around the farm and whatnot, just to get a little extra. Like the little animation there. Whoa, okay. That I'm going back and picking up. That I did not mean to leave. So that about here was two windrows, so we're over 50%. Hopefully we can get a full load here on this next windrow, which we should, so then, yeah, we'll just pick up the rest of this with the forage wagon and we'll call it good. Then we'll take that baler back, or we'll just unhook the baler up here. Forage wagon we'll leave down at the farm, since we have to go back to the farm with it anyways. And I don't know, I may go and just mow some more hay later on, just, you know, to do it, really. Just to have a little extra. And we're full. Just to have a little extra. Make a little extra silage, or, you know, whatever, a little extra hay. There's plenty of grassy area that I can go and mow, so, well, you know, especially all over the map, but even just, you know, around the farm here, like there's that waterway there, all this ditch area. I could have mowed those waterways before that guy went. too, I guess, but. But I didn't think of it until now. Come on, tractor, go. So we'll just go ahead. Hey, moron. Trying to drive here. Ooh, this is heavy. Okay, we better buy a weight for this thing. Weights. We'll get the barrel weight. See what else we got. Alright. Just send that back to the yard. Okay, so we'll go ahead and we'll get this unloaded first before I end the video. They kind of made their fill plane a little too high in that spot. I guess in places it could build up like that on one of these. Yeah, this is definitely heavy. I don't think that International would have made it at all with this thing. So we'll do this bunker here since it's closer. Let's see here. No, I just want the one fill plane back here. So 6%? Yep. Okay. That is pretty good right there. So, oh yeah. We need to hook onto the weight. And then, yeah. So, I will finish collecting this stuff and then get all the bales hauled and get the baler put away and whatnot and all that good stuff. And I missed the weight big time, but yeah, so then the next video we'll work on getting the getting some feed made for the animals and getting them fed, getting them bought even, and whatnot. So yeah guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. There's also my PC specs and the video schedule for every week is also down there. So, yeah, thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.